total with the companies, the foundations, the organizations, and the individuals that are involved in this giving. There are over 100 impassioned champions who have made a difference in the lives of our students here at UC Irvine.
So I originally first met Dr. Lara at a conference here at UCI, and he's very charismatic and very friendly, and that was like leadership that I really kind of wanted to model after.
Older group of individuals who are committed to, you know, the UCI students.
These scholarships have just really allowed me to focus more on the academic as opposed to the financial aspects of my education. I'm a transfer student. I originally attended community college simply due to financial constraints. So just to have these additional funds from these scholarships really just allows me to focus a lot more on my education, and I really appreciate that.
You know, the need for scholarships has in the last few years risen in importance for our students. As we all know, the state's support for the university has been declining, and college costs as a consequence have been rising at a spectacular rate, and jobs have not been that plentiful. So the overall economy has also contributed to this need for providing additional scholarships for our students. And one other aspect which is tremendously important, and that is the impact of this scholarship on first generation students. There's just no more important support that a community can provide its talented students who want to pursue a higher education than to provide them that support to fulfill their dreams.
My experience at UCI without this scholarship would have been difficult. I'm paying for school on my own, so without the scholarship, it's more loans and, you know, more money to pay back eventually. So without it, things would have been much harder.
It's hard for me to imagine. I'm a single mom of two little boys, raising two sons, working full time so that I can go to school, either full or part time. It's just hard to even put that together. I'm really dependent on the grace of scholarships and people who believe in me, and it's the community kind of coming together that's helped me to excel, and I'm excelling as a student. And as a result, my little boys are learning what it means to work hard and to get an education. They don't talk about if they're going to school, they're talking about where. My 12-year-old is talking about Harvard.
You know, as I think about the difference that the donors have made in the lives of our students, there are several things that come to mind. When I think about their contributions, I think about their support, I think about the encouragement that they've provided. What these donors are doing is allowing our students to dream. It's allowing them to focus. It's allowing them to realize the possibility and promise of their potential. And I think that's just outstanding.
Well, this scholarship definitely inspires me because it made me feel like I was worth it enough to be invested in. And so just knowing how I felt after it inspires me to like give back and make other people feel the way that I did.
Because I'm a returning student, I'm 32 years old. I didn't go back to school until I was 28 after I had been divorced and had gotten out of an abusive relationship myself. So like, I want to tell these women, like, you can do this too. Like, it's, you don't have to be young to be at school.
I guess it's not necessarily the scholarship that I think about, the monetary value of it, but I do think about the experiences that it has afforded me. I can wake up in the morning, I can make my daughter breakfast, I can walk her to school, and then I can come on campus, I can participate in my classes.
I think about receiving the scholarship on a day-to-day basis because the scholarship was awarded to me based on the impact that I have made on the Asian American community, and every day I am doing things for my organization, medical, educational missions, and outreach, and every day we are doing something to change another person's life.
Every time I go to class, every time I go to work, every time I do anything, I'm able to do this because of the scholarships that were available to me.
One of the most beautiful parts about my experience with the Manuel Gomez Scholarship, and I think, I hope that this extends to other individuals who have also provided scholarship support, is I get to meet with our students, the scholars that are selected every year, and I get to talk with them. Learn from them about their majors, their interests, their background, their life. The most important thing that happens is that in my life at this stage, as a retired individual perhaps, I now have the time to give the attention to one individual or two individuals, to talk about their interests, to mentor them in essence, even though I don't normally use that formal word. It becomes a mentoring, coaching relationship that gives me great gratification. It makes me feel I'm very much involved in their lives and in their development, and that as they achieve their dreams, I too am proud and happy for them. Perhaps even prouder and happier that since they are going through it, I'm just watching it from the side, helping them any way that I can.
I would describe the heart of people that provide scholarships like mine as extremely generous and selfless, because for somebody to come in and donate the amount of money that they're donating to somebody that they really hardly even know, I think that says a lot about who they are as a person, because I don't think there's a lot of people out there that would work so hard for their money and then just so selflessly give it away like that.
Without knowing me, without seeing my whole situation and getting like the whole picture of who I am, they decided to go ahead and bring this benefit and bring what would be this donation into my life. It really tells about the character that they have.
I'm just convinced that they've allowed our students to dream. They've allowed them to focus. They've allowed them to realize the promise of possibility.
I feel very responsible to live up to the expectation that the donor gave me, because this is my first time getting the scholarship ever in my life, and I never thought that I would ever be a person who can get a scholarship. It gave me the confidence that I can make a difference in the university as well as in society.
Thank you. I know that's simple, but thank you. Thanks for believing in me. There was a time that I didn't believe in myself, and I needed somebody else to believe in me just so I could, you know, take that next step. And without the benefactors, without people just willing and to say we believe in you, who knows where I'd be.
Well, I have to express my gratitude, my deep gratitude to many of the individuals whose name you'll see on this wall, who has supported crucial academic development programs at an early outreach stage. The more I look at this wall, the more I see California goals.